Hello dear students and welcome back. So in our previous video we have discussed about the natural disaster, that is we have discussed about the flood and the lightning. So in this next video we are going to discuss about the natural disaster, that is volcano. So this about the volcano already you have learned in your standard 5th in the CBSE textbook, but again let's revise it. What is meant by volcano? Volcano is a natural event or phenomenon. The interior of the earth is very hot. Movement of hot substances continuously occur from the interior towards the surface of the earth. As a result, sometimes the solid, liquid and the gaseous substance below the earth's crust are pushed towards the crust. Now crust means what? The surface of the earth are having some cracks which are called as what? Crust. Okay. So as we know, the interior of the earth is very hot. In that so many different gases are there. Okay. So in that movement of the hot substances continuously occur from the interior towards the surface of the earth. Okay. So there are the molten rocks are present in the interior part of the earth, and that molten rocks are continuously trying to comes out through the crust. Okay. So sometime what happen with the help of that crust, sometimes that molten substances are erupt. Erupt means what? Suddenly comes out and starts flowing, and it is only called as what? Volcano. And along with that volcano, which things are coming out? Sometimes the solid, liquid and gaseous substances below the earth crust are pushed towards the crust. Okay. So let's see what are the effects of volcano. The chemical substances such as lava, vapor, hot mud, sulfur, etc. get collected on the surface of the earth, and thereby mountains and the hills are created. So sometimes with the help of the volcanoes, chemical substances, which are the chemical substances, we can say that lava, vapor, water vapor, we can say hot mud, sulfur, etc. All these things get collected over each other and it makes the mountains and hills. The atmosphere get polluted due to the ash and gases ejected by the volcano. So as we know, through the volcanoes, tremendous amount of the heat comes out, and because of that, what happened? The atmosphere get polluted. With the help of the volcano, temperature also increases, and due to that ash which is comes out from the volcano, it pollutes the atmosphere. Often it rains as a result of volcanic eruption. Okay. Sometimes it rains also as a result of volcano, because the suddenly temperature increases, so the rate of evaporation increases, which causes the rain. Temperature rises due to hot gases. Okay. Obviously the so many tremendous heat with along with that molten rocks comes out, and which causes the rise in the temperature. Forest and settlements get buried under the hot mud. Okay. So many things are coming out with the volcano, and because of that what happens, so many things are getting buried under the hot mud. Volcanoes erupt in the sea as they do on land. The same substances that comes out during the eruption of the volcano on the land are ejected during the eruption of the volcano in the sea. Some islands are created due to the eruption of volcanoes in the sea. Okay. So this volcano can take place on the land also, and also it can happen in the sea also. Okay. So whatever the things which ejected through the volcano on the land, that same things are also comes out through the volcano in the sea. So because of the volcanic eruption in the sea, some islands are created with the help of the volcano. It is possible to prevent the eruption of volcano, to stop it after it erupts, or to control it. However, by means of the science and technology, it is possible to predict an eruption and to take the immediate steps for disaster management. Okay. So see, it is not possible to stop the eruption of the volcano, to stop it erupt or to control it. But we can come to know when it exactly get erupt through the different science and through the different science tricks and the technology. So it is possible to predict when an eruption of the volcano will take place. So to after because with the help of that, we can take the immediate steps for the disaster management. After that, we'll discuss about the next one, that is what? Tsunami. So on the land, earthquakes and the volcano eruption occur at the bottom of the sea too. On land, the earthquake and the volcanic eruption takes place. But along with the land, the volcanic eruption and the volcanic earthquake and the volcanic eruption also takes place at the bottom of the sea, because as we know, at the bottom of the sea also there is a land. If an earthquake occurs at the bottom of the ocean, the energy released push the water upwards. Okay, so if the earthquake occurs at the bottom of the ocean, then it releases the energy, and because of that energy release, it push the water upward. As a result of this, a peculiar type of waves are formed. Peculiar means very high waves, we can say like that. These waves are not very high near the source, but they start spreading very fast to long distance. Okay, so the peculiar type of the waves means what? They are not that much high. Okay, they are not very high near the source, but the frequency of the wave formation is get increased. Okay, but they start spreading very fast to long distance. They started to get spread very long distance. The velocity of the waves is 800 to 900 kilometer. Okay, so it means this is the speed of the waves. Okay, so the waves velocity is what? 800 to 900 kilometer per hour. So within a 1 hour they can go up to the 800 to 900 kilometer. When they reach a coastal area, their velocity is reduced, but their height is found to have increased tremendously. So when these waves reaches to the coastal area, their height or their velocity get decreases, but their height is get increases tremendously, even to about 30 meters. Okay, up till the 30 meters the height get increased. Okay, so initially it is the waves which do not have very high height, but they near the source, but they start spreading very fast to long distance. They are covering the distance very fast, and what is the speed of them? 800 to 900 kilometer. But as they reach to the coastal area, their speed is get decreased and their height get increased, even to about what? 30 meters. Such a wave generated and by an earthquake or volcanic eruption on the ocean floor is called tsunami. Okay, so such a wave generated by an earthquake or volcano occurring on the ocean floor, and that type of the waves are called as what? Tsunami. Tsunami is a Japanese word which means harbor wave. Okay, which means what? Harbor waves. Okay, next one, destructive effects of tsunami we will see. Building and other constructions are destroyed. There is a large scale loss of life and financial loss also. So there is a large scale loss of life and financial loss. Next one, boat and ship near the coast get damaged. Obviously it will cause the more harms to the coastal area. Trees get uprooted, landslides takes place on the large scale. Sometimes the trees are also comes out, and the landslides means whole mountains or some places are dropped down. Fifth one, changes takes place in the original land near the coast, giving the rise to swamps. Okay, swamps means we can say the area which is get waterlogged all the time. Okay, change takes place in the original land near the coast, giving rise to swamps. Means what? The mangroves nears the swamp region. It means what? The waterlogged places created. Traffic obstruction arises. The business industries related to the sea are adversely affected, and the normal day-to-day life is also get disturbed. Large scale damage is caused to harbors. Okay, so this is all the destructive effects of tsunami. Precautionary measures. When a tsunami wave is formed due to an earthquake on the sea floor, it is necessary that immediate estimate is made of its progress, and a warning of the danger is issued to people in the coastal areas. Okay, so with the help of the weather forecast, with the help of the different technology, we can come to know that there is a possibilities of the tsunami. So with the, according to that, there should be the warning given to the coastal region people. For this purpose, an artificial geostationary satellite is a great use. So with the help of that, we can come to know different states or the different types of the weather condition. Now the next one we will discuss, that what? Storm. So this storm means what? The very high speed of the wind, it is called as what? Storm. Okay. So already we have discussed about the storm in our some previous classes. So this is all about today about the natural disaster, and the one point is that is what national institution. United Nations established a standing international organization in 1965. About 177 nations from all over the world are member of this United Nations established understanding international organization. One of the main function of this organization is to send equipment, financial aids, and also volunteers to the place of the disaster. So what is the work of this organization? If there is any natural disaster, natural calamities is there, then this organization is sending the equipment, also they are providing financial support, and they are sending some volunteers for the help. In addition, international medical team and a group of other experts are also sent. Sometimes they are sending some medical team and a group to help the other people. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have finished this lesson, and for today, thank you.